Is smoking really that bad for you? In this video, I'll be reviewing a recently published research article which discusses the effects of smoking in MS patients taking Tysabri. Want to know the answer? Stay tuned, because I'm going to share starting right now. Howdy! Thanks for learning about MS with me, Aaron Boster. I started this YouTube channel to help my own MS clinic patients learn between clinic visits, and it's my hope that through these videos, I can help you learn too. I recently published an article where I reviewed a research abstract, and I was blown away by the responses. The comments suggested that you guys dig this format, and so I want to try it again. In this video, I'll be discussing another research article. This one focused on the effects of smoking in MS, specifically amongst people taking Tysabri. So let's get started. Here you see the abstract to the article, entitled, Smoking is Associated with Increased Disease Activity During Natalizumab Treatment for Multiple Sclerosis, first author Peterson. This was published in the Journal of Multiple Sclerosis in August of this year. In this study, they examined 355 people with relapsing MS and all taking Tysabri. They started to look at the clinical data at the time Tysabri was initiated, and they followed these patients for a period of 2 years. They determined smoking status based on a questionnaire response that each patient filled out. Now, what they found really struck me. One pack of cigarettes smoked per day, it increased this population's risk of having an attack by 38%. Now let that sink in for a second. Tysabri is a highly effective medicine. And here we have a group of patients taking this highly effective medicine. If the patient smoked, as compared to if they didn't, they literally increased the risk of an attack over the period studied by 38%. They increased it by over a third. That is very, very concerning. In 2018, MS is not a curable condition, but it's a treatable condition. And we want to do anything and everything possible to slow down the disease activity, including stopping or preventing attacks. Here we've learned about a modifiable risk factor, smoking. And yet again, we see strong clinical data suggesting that if you smoke, even if you're taking a highly effective medicine, you increase the risk of clinical attacks. In this study, by 38%. That is a startling statistic. So when I talk about being 4 for 4, and I talk about wanting you to take a medicine, to stay physically active, to supplement low levels of vitamin D, and to not smoke, this is why. I hope that you found the review of this article valuable, and I would love to hear your own personal comments, questions, and thoughts down in the section below. And if you want to hear more content like this video, please take a moment and subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking that little red button. Until my next video, take care.